So now let us discuss about what exactly the pattern was last year. So I think the last year, whatever we had discussions with various students, so basically they first conducted an aptitude assessment. The students who cleared the aptitude assessment, they went through a technical assessment again, and then there were interview rounds. Okay. So now in this video, I'm not going to talk much about the technical assessment because it is a secondary, because I'll make another separate video after the first round results are announced. So the first round is the aptitude assessment, which was conducted last time. It was conducted on HackerRank platform. So this was basically the pattern of the aptitude assessment. It was a 1 hour and 45 minutes of test. There were 68 questions and there were 7 sections. So you could navigate between the sections. So just check, the first section was numerical computations with 8 questions, numerical reasoning with 12 questions. There was comprehension with 10 questions. Abstract reasoning and diagrammatic reasoning with 12 questions each. Logical reasoning, again 12 questions. And there were 2 subjective questions. Now it might happen that you are hearing these some of the words for the first time. So let us check what were the questions in each of these sections. Okay. One more important thing, the marking scheme was you were given 5 marks for the correct answer. There was a negative marking of 2 marks for the wrong answer. And the subjective questions, that is the 2 questions, were for 10 marks each. Okay. So this was the marking scheme. So in numerical computations, there were 8 questions, and these particularly was based on quantitative aptitude, which in general, we know the word quantitative aptitude. So the questions were based on time work, percentage, ratio, divisibility rules, profit loss, fractions, problems on trains, average and permutation combination. So I think you all are familiar with these topics. Okay. Now we are going to make section wise videos on all these particular topics. Okay. So numerical computation, there will be a separate video for Goldman Sachs, which will be uploading very soon. Then there was a numerical reasoning section with 12 questions. So most of the questions in this section were based on letter series, number series. There was a combination of letter and number series. Okay. We need to find the missing number or missing letters. Even there were some questions like, you can say there were figures given, and then there were numbers around those figures, and then one number was missing and we have to find which number was that. So missing number was majorly there in this particular section. Then there was comprehension. This is a reading comprehension. There was a big passage given. I think there were 2 passages with 5 questions on each passage. So this was a basic reading comprehension section. Next was abstract reasoning. It had 12 questions. Now in this type of, in this section, the question types were like finding the number of triangles. So they will give some figure and we have to find the number of triangles in that figure. Then there were questions like the first figure. There is a question figure. It is, we have to fold that figure. They will give the lines where we need to fold. And then we need to answer which, after folding, which figure will be formed from the given options. Okay. Then there was a problem figure and the answer figure. We need to find out the correct answer figure or which figures appears next in the series. Such type of questions were there. Then there were questions like finding code for given figure by relating the codes of figure given in question. So there is a figure given in question and it has some codes. And then there is a figure given in the another figure given for which we have to find the code. Okay. So don't worry, these type of questions might seem new to you, but we are going to again upload these questions on our YouTube channel so that you can prepare for your test. Okay. Next is diagrammatic reasoning. Now, this was something new which students did not expect. Okay. Because it is something, there were figure based questions, but there was like operators, symbols, every operator meant something, symbols meant something. There were circuit diagrams. Okay. Not exactly electronic circuit diagrams, but there were circuit diagrams using AND or operator. There was a switch, bulb, and then they were asking questions like whether the bulb will glow or not. Okay. Then there was a dice which had its faces numbered, and the dice was rolled or moved to a particular position on a graph, and then questions based on it were asked. Okay. Then there were questions like the word was given, in between there were symbols, and then was question mark. Such questions were there. Flowchart based questions were there. So this is something very new, and it is really important that you need to understand how to solve these kind of questions. So we are also going to make separate video on diagrammatic reasoning also. So make sure you are always tuned to our channel, because these kind of questions, if this pattern repeats again this time, then it is going to be very, very important for you to understand this type of questions. Then there were 12 questions of logical reasoning. Again, this is familiar to you. Sitting arrangement questions, data interpretation, coding decoding. I was surprised that the questions from calendar and clock were also there in logical reasoning. Okay, and then there were some questions on direction sense. Then comes the subjective question. There were two questions basically, and those were situational based questions, or they used to ask opinions on the situation given. There was one question like, you are having your term exam next week and you are also called for an interview suddenly for the internship. So what will be your reaction, or how would you react, or what would be your planning? So such kind of questions were there. So those questions are merely to understand how your personality is, how you can handle situations. So those were subjective questions. So this was basically the pattern for the first round last time when the test was conducted in the month of August. If they follow the same pattern, then definitely the preparation videos which we are going to make will be definitely very, very useful for all of you. Okay. So thank you for watching the video till the end. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Again, I will declare all the preparation videos for Goldman Sachs will be provided free of cost on our YouTube channel, and the updates will be given in the WhatsApp group. So don't forget to join the WhatsApp group. Link is given in the description of this video. Thank you for watching the video and see you all in the next video.